Hello, in this video, I'm going to be talking about tumor resistance. How do cancer cells become resistant? What does it mean, and what do we do when that happens? This topic came up because we were asked about this in one of the comments. Before I go on, I'd love to invite you to subscribe to our channel because, as you can see, we respond to things you ask us to respond to, sometimes by creating new videos. And we're always putting out new content based on new studies that have come out, new things that are available. I'd also love to invite you to go to yerbba.com to get your personalized report. So what is tumor resistance? What does that mean? In general, when people talk about a tumor being resistant, they say that it's no longer or never did respond to a given treatment. Tumors can be resistant to chemotherapy, to endocrine therapy, to targeted therapy, and even to radiation therapy. So primary resistance means the tumor never responded. It was that way out of the gate. It was just resistant to that treatment from day one. Acquired resistance is when a treatment was working and then the tumor started to grow again, even when that treatment continued. So that's often what we see in people with advanced or metastatic cancer, where they're responding to a treatment and then it stops working. So why does this happen? Well, it happens because, well, we can talk about primary resistance first. Primary resistance is due to the fact that tumors are very clever. They don't have a brain, obviously, but they are designed to be able to grow. They thrive because they're able to outsmart treatments. They outsmarted your immune system. They outsmarted the part of the immune system called the natural killer cells, and they can outsmart chemotherapy and other treatments. In fact, if you think about normal cells, our normal cells are amazing. We have what are called efflux pumps in our normal cells that pump out toxins. So if you're exposed to something your body doesn't want to see, the cells will pump that compound, that chemical, out of your body. I think that's amazing. And tumor cells, as we know, are normal cells, just kind of jacked up. They've got a lot of mutations, and they survive because they develop these resistance mechanisms. The particular one that is sort of the most well-known are these efflux pumps. Instead of influx, where the chemical goes into the cell, it's efflux. It pumps them out. It uses energy and pumps stuff out of the cells. So primary resistance comes about that way. Acquired resistance can develop when there develops an efflux pump. Acquired resistance can also happen because the tumor cells develop more mutations, and now the treatment, which relied on that original cell's mutations, is now being sort of outsmarted, or it's maybe a better way to think of it is the cell develops a workaround. Those mutations allow the cells to work around that chemical. And the more cells are in the body and the longer they're there, the more workarounds they develop. Just like a very experienced person in your office knows more workarounds than somebody who just started the next day, the day before. The other thing to know is that if we didn't give a treatment, acquired resistance wouldn't develop. So what that means is that when you see somebody who dies of breast cancer because their cancer became resistant, that's sort of the end pathway for every cancer cell. At some point, if there are enough cancer cells that are resistant to a treatment, the person will be overwhelmed by cancer cells. It doesn't mean that we should not have treated them, because without the treatment, the cancer cells would have overwhelmed the body even earlier. The idea of resistance is the reason we often give two drugs together, especially when the goal is cure. We have data that giving one drug and another drug that work different ways helps overcomes resistance to one drug by hitting it with the other drug. So they tend to work two different ways. We wouldn't give two taxanes together. We give an anthracycline and a taxane, or we give a platin agent plus a taxane, because they work entirely different ways, and the hope is to overcome resistance. I'm hoping that makes sense. Drop a comment or question if it doesn't. The other thing is that cells can become resistant to hormonal therapies. They develop workarounds as well, and that's why we switch treatment. Really, resistance is why we switch to another treatment. It's probably the most common reason. The other reasons we switch are things like side effects or people's inability to tolerate the medication. We'll switch to a different drug. But if you're on one medication and the doctor says it stops working or it didn't work, they'll put you on another medication, the hope being that that drug will work and that the cancer cells won't be resistant to that next drug. It's also important to know that in one tumor, there are different kinds of cells. So in a tumor, let's imagine a tumor that you can measure. Some of those cells will be sensitive to treatment A, and some will be resistant. So all the cells that are sensitive will die. And what that does is it leaves those resistant cells. And as you know, cancer cells divide. That's kind of how they survive. So all the sensitive cells are gone, and now all that is left are these robust, resistant cells. And we are sort of selecting out. We're selecting for the strongest, most resistant cells. I know this sounds scary, but that's why we come in with another treatment, or that's why we might switch treatment or do radiation therapy, so that any cells that might have escaped chemotherapy in the breast, let's say you have breast surgery and then chemo, we want to make sure any cells that were resistant to chemotherapy, we can kill with radiation therapy. This is why combination therapy is so important in breast cancer surgery to remove the cells. Different chemotherapy or targeted therapy or endocrine therapy and radiation therapy all work together to try to get every last cell, and if not, make the cell fragile or make it dormant for many years. And if they're not dividing, cancer cells often just sort of die off on their own. This is pretty technical. I know you can understand this. If any of it was confusing, just watch the video again. And then, of course, drop comments or questions below. If you're an expert in tumor resistance, we would love to hear from you. I use a lot of metaphors, and sometimes they don't resonate. And if you are an expert in tumor resistance, maybe you'll have a different way of explaining it that will be useful to the Yerbba community. As always, thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.